Hey, what's going on, guys? This chapter, I'm going to already tell you, got a 10 out of 10, a 20 out of 10. No, it's not because Guy finally opened up the Death Gate. He looks fucking awesome. I mean, his hair is on fire, his eyebrows are on fire, which looks hilarious yet awesome at the same time. Guy is about to go in, and it's not because of the symbolism of what Guy said at the end about his leaves being the nourishment to the new leaves, and it was like showing Lee. That was so symbolic, but the real reason is completely a personal reason. Guy's dad reminds me of my dad. I'm about to go into a little JB history moment, so bear with me. Okay, so even though he's not really my blood dad, he was still awesome. My real dad is an asshole. I do not like him one bit. And this guy came in and saved me and my mom from this crazy motherfucker. And I mean, no matter what anyone said about him, because I'm not going to say he was strange, but he had his own ways, kind of like I do. He liked different things than other, people of color. Like, he wasn't your stereotypical African American adult, I guess you could say. And because of where we lived at the time, he got talked about a lot. And just seeing how Guy's dad was talked about in this chapter, and Guy's dad pretty much saying thanks for the encouragement, even though everyone was pretty much talking down on him and pretty much saying fuck you, die, and he was saying thank you. That's how my dad was. So that already, it reminded me so much of him to the point where it was almost painful to keep on reading. But the good memories outweigh the bad, so it really was a good thing. This chapter brought out some, emotions in me that hasn't happened in a manga like ever. I mean, because Guy's dad straight up reminds me of my dad because he rescued me and my mom from this crazy mess, and he didn't give a fuck about what anyone else thought. And my dad, like, no joke, actually said thank you when people said fuck you for real. So I mean, it was just a real nostalgic feeling in my own life. So that's why I'm giving this chapter a 10 out of 10. Guy's dad is awesome, and I think I can relate to Guy in this situation because I mean, my father passed away from a heart attack, and I understand what Guy is going through when he's thinking back about the lessons that his dad taught him. And I go through that a lot, so that's another reason this chapter was such a heartfelt chapter to me. It's like one of the best in recent memory, in my opinion, just because of that. You may not like it, but like I said, I have my own personal reasons for liking it. Enough of the sad stuff, let's get back to the big dick Uchiha jokes and borderline gay puns. Someone please clear this up for me. Has there ever been any confirmation about how the swordsman died? Because if there wasn't before, there damn sure is now. Might died just straight up murked them with the Death Gate, and it's hinting that he sacrificed his life to save his son and his comrades, which is awesome. And Mike Guy is about to do the same thing. And just seeing the shots of Lee crying, but yet, like, somehow it seems like he's ready to accept this. Like, he knows this is what Guy wants to do, and this is what he has to do. And it looks like Lee is ready to fill the shoes of Guy already. And I'm crossing my fingers that there is something to prevent his death. But I mean, it is the Death Gate, so unless someone comes in and heals him, or someone with the Rinnai Tensei or something like that, and after these awesome attacks, Guy is unfortunately going to be joining his father. And the ending, oh man, got me so hyped. I believe it said one of his techniques was burning elephants. I mean, oh my God, this guy is about to go straight up beast mode. But the question is, how much damage will it deal on Madara? I mean, the big dick Uchiha is pretty much, he has the biggest dick right now. His dick can be compared to the God's tree size. So at this point, the real question is, will Guy do all of this in vain? Will he lose his life in vain? I hope he at least damages Madara to the point where someone like Naruto and Sasuke, or maybe a combination of both, can defeat him. But I would just hate for Guy to go all out. I mean, his flesh and soul is literally burning right now. I would hate for him to go through all of this pain and not even put a scratch on Madara. That would be bullshit. I would be so fucking upset. I looked back, and the name of the technique is Night Elephant, not Burning Elephant, although Burning Elephant sounds more awesome to me. But just imagine, his Midday Tiger or Hirudora is literally like a huge tiger. So what if he is like a big charging flaming elephant. That would be so fucking badass. But God moved so flipping fast that he surprised even the big dick Uchiha. Did you see Madara's face when God pretty much teleported right in front of him? And that's saying a lot coming from the guy who just literally flew over there DBZ style. So guy is about to fuck some shit up. Fuck, man. Poor Lee. I mean, his comrade died. Now it seems like his sensei and pretty much father figure is about to die as well, or so it seems, man. Lee is going to be so fucking awesome if they are not brought back via some Renny Tensei bullshit at the end of this anime. Lee is going to be so fucking hardcore. And just looking at what few pages were shown of Might Die, guy is just like his father. I mean, he makes corny but yet hilarious jokes just like his father. He cries all the time. You're talking about youth. He is his father, pretty much. It's always nice to see your favorite characters and to see where they came from and just to see how they compare to their parents or ancestors. And I was not disappointed with this chapter at all. But it finally happened. We're finally about to witness the true power of the Death Gate. Bushier Brow Sensei just turned into the burning Bushier Brow Sensei. So tell me what you guys think. Do you think Might Guy is about to Taijutsu Madara's big dick off? What do you think is going to happen? I am so hyped to see what this guy is going to do. That night elephant technique is going to be awesome. I already know it. But anyway, tell me what you guys think. This has been JB the Chia. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'm out.